Art brings emotion to those teetering on the precipice of apathy, and hope to those in danger of wallowing in despair. This year, we are focusing on the artist's perseverance, the desire to keep creating when all seems lost. VM470 Crossing Zoom Horizons is an experimental exhibition featuring works of 2D and 3D animation, virtual reality, physical puppetry, and even artificial intelligence.
And I just really wanted to hug myself. And I always wondered how to express that feeling and that sensation. And that's how I came upon my leaf.
Fashion and virtual reality have this aspect of three-dimensionality to them that I'd like to explore in terms of how we express ourselves and our bodies.
Hello everyone, I am Tien Olivia Yang, and my project is about a girl exploring her adopting family in the far east of the world.
Let's do this!
Yes, I did a 2D animated short film about a girl, a dog, and a frog, and it's about not bottling up your emotions.
I've been focusing on people I don't know's day to day. It exists both as an Instagram and a website in which there's these little box rooms of GIFs of faces of these people doing their daily thing.
If we were all able to speak one language, we'd be able to overcome so many things. And then I realized that the one language that we all do speak is the visual language.
Through games, I feel like no matter what part of the world you live in, you can experience like a whole different life and way of living and culture, and I think that's really informative.
House Point, only for Game Boy and Super Game Boy.
I don't know how indicative that was of that actual game. My project is a combination between a Game Boy RPG and a VR archery game. In both games, you play as a spirit who's trying to protect the last remaining forest against an evil corporation who's trying to destroy the planet. But it's not as intense as it sounds.
So I decided that I was going to do something spontaneous after COVID. In the fall, I created an animatic, and then, so this semester, I turned it into a comic book, just because I'm really interested in story art.
Using my own emotional associations as a guide, I created two opposing rooms that kind of create a dichotomy of emotions, which is serenity and stress.
Last semester, I wrote a thesis, and I decided to make an accompanying game alongside of it and to sort of tackle a lot of the stereotypes that are perpetuated in yaoi. I wanted to make a game that tackled that and was sort of aware of it.
I wanted to make it more meaningful and more challenging, so procedurally generated world. The idea is you want to jump as far as possible, as high as possible. I re-edited the whole particle system, so I think it's authentic enough. Yeah.
It revolves around a dancer that gets into an accident and has to learn how to dance with newly added prosthetic limbs, with a right arm and a left leg. And so it's a battle for adversity.
And my work is Confined, and it's based off from a short story that I wrote. It's a story about a misunderstood witch who died of a tragedy. And just be careful not to get lost, because you might never find your way out.
Nothing will stop us from pushing forward and satiating the human need to be creative.